Welcome, dear student, in the paper Animal Diversity 3rd. In this paper, we are dealing with the classification, systematic position or arrangement of the chordate. And this for this semester, we are only going to deal with the chordate classification. And from this chordate classification, we have completed the characters of chordate, then distinguishing characters of the chordate and non-chordate, along with the group protochordate. And from this first group protochordate, we have finished the characters of subphylum Hemichordata and subphylum Urochordata. And this protochordata is again having the third subphylum, that is Cephalochordata. So today we will see the subphylum Cephalochordata along with the classification and its character. So let's see the subphylum Cephalochordata. As you know very well, the characters about the Hemichordata and Urochordata, all these are the primitive chordate. In case of hemichordates, the notochord, which generally said to be the present in proboscis, it is nothing but the buccal diverticulum, and it is somewhat doubtful. That's why the hemichordates are kept into a separate phylum. And in case of urochordate, notochord which is present in the larval stage, and as it converts from larvae to adult, the notochord disappears. But here, in case of cephalochordate, these are the only individuals from this protochordate in which the notochord remain as it is throughout life. So these are the first individuals from this protochordates in which persistent notochord is present. So let's see the characters of cephalochordate. They are marine, widely distributed in shallow waters, mostly sedentary and buried, with only the anterior body end projecting above bottom sand for feeding purpose, and rest of the body is under the sand. They are smaller in size, measuring 5 to 8 cm long. They are having the cylinder structure, fish-like, segmented and transparent. Body has trunk and tail. The head is absent. Paired appendages are also absent, but the median fins are present. Exoskeleton is absent and epidermis is single layer. Muscles are dorsolateral, segmented into myotomes. Coelom is entrocoelous, that is the coelom which is going to be formed from the mesodermal pouches of Archenteron. These are going to happen in the embryonic development. As the embryo develops, the mesodermal pouches of the archenterons, which form this coelom, and such coelom is called as entrocoelous. And basically, this is done into the deuterostome individual, in which the blastopore develops into an anal opening. So these are in the chordates, which are deuterostomes. And the coelom, which is reduced in the pharyngeal region by development of atrial cavity. Notochord, rod-like, persistent, extending from rostrum to tail, from anterior to posterior sides, and it is dorsal in position. And hence the name Cephalochordata. alimentary canal or the digestive tract is complete. It has the large pharynx perforated by numerous persistent gill slits opening into atria. Respiration through general body surface and special organs for respiration absent. Circulatory system is well developed. It is a closed type but without heart and respiratory pigment. Hepatic portal system is developed. As the alimentary canal is complete, so hepatic portal system is also developed. But the respiratory pigment is absent in the circulatory fluid along with the heart. The removal of nitrogenous waste is carried out by the protonephridia with solenocytes. So these are the this primitive structure for removal of nitrogenous waste. Nerve cord, which is also dorsal, tubular, without ganglia and brain. Dorsal and ventral nerve roots are separate. Sexes are separate. About 25 pairs of gonads are present, gonoducts absent, and no asexual reproduction. That means the individual do not have the asexual reproduction. It has the separate sexes, and both separate sexes, male and female, produces the male and female gamete respectively. Fertilization is external in seawater. Both the sexes are separate, but the fertilization is external. That is, gametes are released by the male and female outside the body. So the number of gametes are released to increase the chances of fertilization, and they get fertilized outside the body into the seawater. Development is indirect, including a free swimming larva. So the larval form is present just like that of the hemichordata, which is also having the tarnaria larva, urochordata, which is having the tadpole larva. Here also in cephalochordate, it is also having the free swimming larva. These cephalochordates has about 30 different species of the genus Branchiostoma, and all put in the class Leptocardia. So these 30 species are confined from cephalochordates, and these 30 species are just taken into a single class Leptocardia. So it is the subphylum Cephalochordata has a single class Leptocardia. These are the general characters of Cephalochordata. Let's see the classification. As it has only one class, Leptocardia, which is having all the species of this Branchiostoma, and these individuals are having the fish-like body, somewhat laterally compressed, with a median fin is present. Segmented body is also present with the numerous gill slits, and they are free swimming and burrowing individual. They are commonly called as Lancet, and the example is Branchiostoma, that is Amphioxus and Osimetron. So these are the two representative examples from subphyla cephalopod. So likewise, these are the characters and classification of subphylum cephalopod. So with this we have completed the all three subphyla from group Protochordata, which are the Hemichordata, Urochordata and Cephalochordata. We have also studied the two representative examples from all these three subphyla. From Hemichordata, we have studied the two examples. One is a Balanoglossus and another is Rhabdopleura. Then from Urochordata, we have studied the example Hardmania and Salpa. And now from this cephalochordate, the two examples are Branchiostoma or Amphioxus and Persimetra. So likewise, these are two representative examples from each subphyla of group Protochordata. All these protochordates are primitive chordate because all these individuals possesses the basic fundamental character of chordate. And you know very well the basic fundamental character of chordate, which are these: the dorsal tubular cylindrical this notochord, and again dorsal hollow nerve cord and pharyngeal gill slits. So this notochord, nerve cord and gill slits, pharyngeal gill slits, these are the basic fundamental characters of chordate. Hope you understand all these characters of these three respective subphylums: Hemichordata, Urochordata and Cephalochordata. But still, if you have any doubt or the query, please comment it into the comment box. And please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for latest videos of this SY Zoology Animal Diversity 3rd paper. Thank you very much.